Hello and welcome to our ABB Electrification Business Roundtable together with ABB's Global Head for Building and Home Automation Solutions, Thorsten Müller, ABB's Global Head for E-Mobility Infrastructure, Frank Mühlon, and ABB's Global Head of Marketing and Sales for the Smart Buildings Business Line, Adalbert Neumann. Adalbert, first question directly for you. During the novelty presentation, we talked a lot about products, of course, but ABB is much more: a trendsetter, a visionary, a partner for your customers, a matchmaker for experts from various industries, and you are on a grand mission, the mission to zero for smart cities. So please tell us a bit more about your mission.
Yeah, this is a very good question. Mission to zero for smart cities is something which is really in the heart of the DNA of ABB Electrification. And with good technology, with interesting solutions and combined offers, we are able to deliver solutions for sustainable office buildings, factories, and so on. And ABB is doing this not since yesterday. So we have a good experience since over 40 years in energy management. But today we are doing this in a way which is quite different. And I have an example. In the factory for wiring accessories in Lüdenscheid of Buschega, where we are producing dimmers and switches and sockets and free at home and KNX, there we got the possibility to have a photovoltaic installation on the parking place for the employees. And this is an installation of 1.3 megawatt. And this installation is combined with a solar inverter, with medium voltage, with a ABB battery system, and with Frank's nice power charger for the electrical cars of the employees and of our customers. So with this installation combined with the software which is connected to the utility, we can showcase what is possible as a mission to zero, because this factory is running nearly carbon dioxide neutral. In summer times, we are just only connected to the sun and the energy of the sun. And in winter times, we have a situation that we are also buying energy from water power, wind power, to fill the gap what we need for the factory. It's not just only the factory. We have also the office building, and the office building is installed with KNX, where we have energy management in the office building. The interesting point is the software in combination, where everything will be controlled and the software is intelligent, smart and adaptable for the different situations. With this installation, we are reducing around 630 tons of carbon dioxide per year, and this is something really very special. And what I would like to say is also, it's not just only for factories to have this kind of installation. You can scale it down to a single family house where you have a photovoltaic panel and where you have an electrical car and you have a battery system where you can use this kind of solution from us. But you can have it also for a supermarket or for an office building or for other applications. I can tell you already some of our suppliers copy-pasted this solution and it's running quite well. So from that point of view, the world is running to be more sustainable. And with this first really running application in the ABB factory world, we can show that this is working with technology which is already available.
So you are a true inspiration also for your customers.
Yes.
Great, okay. Thorsten, in times of digitalization, it is of course crucial to join forces, team up with the right partners, and also open up your system for third-party solutions. So tell us a bit more about your partner network, which enables then you to offer a holistic, smart experience for your customers.
First of all, we think there are two drivers for the whole thing. We have the demand by our clients that they can connect everything to the same system. And on the other side, we see that platforms become more and more important. And in order to leverage both, we have the idea of open APIs. Industry standard APIs where everyone can connect to. And let me give you three examples. They are completely different, starting with the hospitality sector, where we have a cooperation with Better Space 360, which allows to connect our building assets towards a holistic hotel management system. So this gives a much better customer experience for the hotel clients, but at the same time, it improves the processes inside the hotel. The second cooperation I'd like to mention is called Holistic. So it's a very generic platform so that every end user can define simple rules and connect assets of different companies. And last but not least, talking about crowdsourcing, We have a collaboration with Homey Alarm. It's a US-based company who has the idea that in case I have an intrusion inside my building, I can alert my neighbors, because my neighbors are my friends and they can react if I'm not at site. So basically, you can see it's really a broad range,
sure,
all
is
enabled by the same technology.
Exciting. Are there more corporations also in other fields? Frank?
Yeah, of course. Also in the e-mobility space, it's an ecosystem, right? And in an ecosystem, you cannot work without partners. You need the charging infrastructure and the cars to work together, to communicate together flawlessly, seamlessly. And so this is why we work with partners, mainly with the car manufacturers, with the OEMs together. Also, these OEMs roll out networks, charging networks, so they are our customers, but so are utilities, so are independent charge point operators. So all of this is partners in that ecosystem, bringing it forward, or also on the software side or payment terminal providers. And if you just look at the two largest networks we have out there, it's like Ionity in Europe, for example, or Electrify America in the United States. They're both originated from car manufacturers. So that is all partnerships we have, we drive, and we're very happy about. But of course, beyond that pure business aspect, and we also have a fun aspect, which is the ABB Formula E. So that's an ecosystem where actually all kinds of partners are brought together, and we can, on a very nice play field, collaborate and bring technology and e-mobility forward and bring it closer to consumers and use that as a test bed. Now, even closer to consumers is if you take a real-life car like the Jaguar I-PACE. So we are official charging partner for the I-PACE trophy, which is also a very nice experience.
Yeah. And you have a new cooperation with Porsche?
Also, we have that, right? Specifically in the Asia-Pacific region or Japan, where we will supply the charging infrastructure for their dealerships. So that is also something we're very happy about.
Exciting, absolutely. Mm. And there is no smart city without smart mobility. So what's the growth outlook for your sector?
Yeah, the growth outlook is just great. I mean, we see really e-mobility on the uptake. So we have grown our business significantly. And if we look in the market going forward, there's all kinds of statistics. So which one you believe is a different question. But so roughly like in 2040, we will see about half a billion, so 500 million battery electric vehicles globally on the road. So that's a figure which is quite impressive, I believe. And by then, also more than half of the new releases to the market will be electric. So that means there's significant uptake for us. The only question is when exactly will that happen? And of course, the determining factor of when this will happen is around the battery technology, but it's also around the availability of the right vehicles. So there is fireworks coming from the OEMs around this, and if this is happening, I think we urgently need to reinforce the grid, build out our solution stronger, and of course, this only makes sense if we have renewable energy. So also there, we need to take a step forward. So this is why we have to look a bit further into the future, but we will see this inflection point coming.
And when you look at e-mobility, there are many different requirements. Mm-hmm. So do you offer a solution for every requirement? What's special about your technology?
Mm-hmm. So we are not the ones offering a special solution for every special requirement, because that is then very unique. So what we need in e-mobility much more is standards, so that you have a seamless integration as a customer with the infrastructure and between the vehicles. So we work alongside standards, and with those standards try to bring e-mobility forward. So we have been funding members of the CHAdeMO Association, funding members of the CHARIN Association, funding members of Opportunity Charging when it comes to buses. We work alongside open APIs to be really integrative, and also to integrate in like Torsten's solution of free at home, and to have a joint energy management system. Also, if you consider that about if you have a residential building and a battery electric vehicle, probably half of your consumption might be coming from the car.
During our novelty presentation, we saw a lot of innovations in the field of KNX. When a couple of years back, you very successfully launched Free at Home, people might have thought, okay, now you go up that direction and you have a new focus. But that's not true, obviously.
The thought is quite interesting because free at home is really, really successful all over the world. So you can find free at home in Australia, everywhere in Europe, in UAE, in Northern Europe, Eastern Europe, and also in Mexico, for example. But it's just a system which is working for single family houses, for apartments and multifamily houses. So when we started to think about free at home and the development, we asked a lot of customers, end customers, what is your really need? And there was the interconnectivity, interoperability. They were asking for a simply solution. And from that point of view, if you are looking into market segments, this was a, let's say, the segment below KNX, and this was the starting point for the development of free at home. By the way, a very fast development was just only 9 months from the idea to go to the market. So this was fantastic. And if you're looking to the years after the launch of free at home, we brought a lot of new products for free at home, but we brought much more KNX products to the market, also targeting new segments. And KNX is typically in the high-end private house, in the commercial building, in hotel buildings, and in industrial applications. So from that point of view, the complexity is even higher, and the possibilities are also different than you need it in free at home. So from that point of view, KNX is for us still very important, and you know we were a founder of KNX in 30 years ago. And today, I think we are one of the manufacturers with the broadest assortment. And today, there are around 500 manufacturers in the market working every day for KNX solutions and products. From that point of view, it's very interesting for us also to be there in the future. And around 100,000 system integrators are working every day with our products and with the products of the other KNX manufacturers. There was just only one area in the product field where we are not able to deliver solutions. And this was the area of HVAC control connected to the KNX. And there was just only a small solution. It was ClimaEcho. But there is something new, and you will hear about it.
Yeah, that changed now because you acquired Silent Control. So tell us a bit more about Silent Control, the company itself, and how this move fits into your overall strategy.
We touched base today already quite several times about that we want to optimize the energy consumptions of buildings. As I said, we have a good access to the KNX network, so that is already a major part of the energy consumptions within a building. But our clear ambition is to have a holistic energy management. And that was the reason why we, for example, integrated Frank's Charger into the building software. But there was one area of energy consumption where we did not really had access to, and that's HVAC control. And basically, Silent is a world-leading provider of HVAC control solutions, both at the field level, so that we can interact with different HVAC manufacturers, but also they provide very interesting software suites which enable both building management as well as holistic energy management in the building. And that's basically where Silent story kicks into our overall energy management picture. So now we have the complete portfolio and we can provide to our customers holistic solutions.
Gentlemen, I feel like we could keep on talking for hours. So many exciting topics we have, but for now, let me thank you for these really inspiring insights. Thank you very much. And if you want to find out more, please also visit ABB's website. Of course, we hope to see all of you back soon. In the meantime, let's create a safer, smarter, and more sustainable world together. Thanks for watching.